From climbing Everest to setting a world record for crossing the Great Himalayan Trail, this man has done it all. His name is Sean Burch, and he's here with us to share stories about being an adventure traveler. Sean, thank you so much for being here.
Oh, pleasure. Thanks for having me.
So I thought I was adventurous and I thought I was fit, but you have taken it to a completely another level. Tell us how you got into adventure traveling.
I was always into fitness, so that I was always in good shape. But my last conversation with my grandfather, he was a big, huge influence on me. Big adventure, been around the world. And just before he had passed away, our last conversation, he kind of set the tone of what I needed to do. Was I completely happy? Mm-hmm. If not, live your life to the fullest. And do what those things that you've set back in your mind and make them a reality. So after he passed away, it just totally changed my life. And then I started going on the path to reaching my goals.
That was the push to set you on the path.
Yeah, unfortunately, it took his death to do that, you know, but it changed my life forever, yeah.
If someone is kind of thinking about starting to get more into, they love to travel, but they're kind of interested in getting more into the adventure travel, where do you think someone should start?
Well, first you need to get, to me, it's like you always get a passport, right? You get it, so yeah. There's no excuses. And second of all, there's 166 countries around the world that any U.S. citizen can visit that either not required for a visa, or you can get a visa right there at the airport. Like in Nepal, you can go right to the airport and they'll get you a visa. So there's really no excuse not to travel anywhere. So my suggestion would be to get the passport, go to an area, research it a little bit, mm-hmm. and make sure it's an adventure. I mean, the idea of a trip, to me, that's business, which is great, but it's business. Adventure has that connotation, right? It's like automatically you're excited, right?
Yeah.
It's an adventure. So it has to be an adventure, knowing the fact that things are not gonna always go your way. But you will learn from that, mm-hmm. and that's why I do what I do, because I get to learn from each expedition that I go on around the world.
Pretty much been everywhere. What is next on the list?
Well, Antarctica is always on the list. It's just a matter of getting sponsors, getting people who believe in what you're doing, the expedition you're trying to do, mm-hmm. and then seeing that to fruition. But Antarctica is not something I just want to go down there and see the penguins. I don't like to do what everybody else is doing. I want to go down there for 2 months. I want to explore, so we'll see, but it's always there. Yeah.
Well, you've written this book, Hyper Fitness, 12 Weeks to Conquering Your Inner Everest and Getting into the Best Shape of Your Life.
Yeah.
How do you stay fit while you're on the road?
Well, to me, is you have to exercise every day, do something, whether it's doing bodyweight exercises in a hotel or whether it's walking and seeing the city. Like when I'm in Kathmandu, I've been there 7-8 times, but I'll still every day I'll do a workout in my hotel, mm-hmm. and then I'll go and I'll just walk the entire city,
which is a great form of exercise.
Absolutely.
And a great way for anyone to start. You're seeing everything, but you're also exercising.
Exactly. Most people can, if they just walk, that's movement, that's enough. Uh-huh. And if you're doing an adventure, you might want to get into a program or do something to take you to that next level.
I really like it. So we've been all over the place. Antarctica is next. And just what are your kind of words of advice, for someone who just really wants to adventure travel?
Is you're capable of doing more than you think you are. That's it. Don't ever shoot for average. I think a lot of people shoot subpar, right? They mm-hmm. It's for somebody else. And that's how I lived my life for a long time was, I want to climb Everest, but that's, there's not too many high altitude peaks where I live.
Where can people find more information?
They can find more information on my website, seanburch.com, or contact me there or go on my social media.
And thank you so much for being here. I'm going to start my adventure traveling. We've got to take a quick break, but we've got lots more planned for you, so don't go anywhere. You have inspired me.